गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। गुड
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
यस्टरडे वी Yesterday we talked about all of the different hardwoods that are available and their properties and their characteristics, the color, the grain, and today we are continuing with that. So we were talking about Saigon and or tea. And how it is a well-rounded wood, which is durable in all kinds of external climates and conditions, and sunlight, rain, frost, snow. So it's suitable and very good for outdoor construction, for furniture. But it's also very expensive, and it is hard to find. And it is hard to find not only because it is a hardwood and hardwood trees take time to grow to mature, but also because it is an endangered species of trees. So, like I told you yesterday, it is endangered, and the government of India has banned the use or procurement or trade of any new teak wood. However, we can still use reclaimed teak wood and old furniture and wood from old constructions. And the last type of hardwood that we're going to talk about is rosewood, and rosewood, and as it is commonly known in India, shisham. Rosewood trees are typical to tropical environments, including Brazil, India, and Madagascar. It is durable when it is dried properly, and it comes with white chalky deposits that may dull tools and present problems with finishing. Meaning, within the wood itself, first of all, it must be processed properly. It should be dried properly, otherwise it won't be as durable. And within the wood, there are chalk-like deposits, meaning there are pockets of this substance, which is white and chalk-like, and which causes a problem when you're processing it, when you're working with this wood, with shisham, because it will dull your tools. If you're using a saw or finishing it with some kind of a sandpaper or something, it will wear out or dull out your tools very easily. So you'll have to keep replacing the blade quite soon, sooner than you would normally do. But once it is completed in construction or you've used it in a furniture, it is one of the most durable and toughest woods. The color of rosewood and the hardwood varies from golden brown to deep purplish brown. Here in this image, the color is deep purplish brown. However, it can still be a little lighter golden brown. And the streaks or the grain in it is dark brown. Then it has a very high density, which makes it quite hard, and it is heavy and it's strong. Then the grain is usually narrowly interlocked, meaning if you notice closely in this image that you'll see that the grain isn't exactly straight, and they're kind of intersecting and interlocking, forming loops and waves. And then the most common uses for rosewood are high-end furniture because it is quite difficult to work with and it is not easily available. And in musical instruments, in veneer, because these are all highly valued woods, rosewood, teak wood, and even oak wood, walnut, mahogany. So people want this look. They want their furniture to look like it's made out of shisham, but maybe they might not be able to afford a solid rosewood furniture or something. So what they go for is veneers. That's why they're you'll find a lot of veneers in these finishes or made out of these woods. And again, turned wood objects. Turned, I already told you yesterday, turned woods are, you, hold on, I'll show you an image of what turning a piece of wood means. There's a machine, it's called a lathe, and you, hold on. See, so this is a machine which has a narrow, you know, needle-like thing on it, where you fix the wood, a piece of wood on it, and then there's this blade. See, you fix the wood here, right? And then there's this blade and one over here, which you can move inwards or outwards and along the piece of wood. So what it'll do is it can cut your carve your wood into these designs or any design you want. So it's used to make bowls, utensils, plates, banisters, baseball bats, handles, and all of those things. See, it rotates, it spins it at a very, very high speed. So you just have to, you know, touch your blade or tools to it and it will start cutting the wood. So that's what this whole process is called. So it's called turning wood. And this machine is called a lathe. Okay, so these were all the hardwoods: shisham, sagon, beech, cherry, birch, ash, red oak, walnut, and mahogany. There are more, but these are the most common ones that are most commonly available in India or are frequently imported to India. Then we come to softwoods. Softwoods usually consist of trachytes and wood rays, but lacks vessels, meaning, when you see a cross section of hardwood, it has capillaries to carry water to the leaves, because these are very high, very tall trees, and you'll see tiny vessels cut when you see a cross section of it. But softwoods are usually derived from coniferous trees, which are found in colder climates, and they have a conical structure and they're deciduous, they have needles, so their internal makeup is different than hardwoods. So instead of carrying those vessels, they have a trachytes and wood rays. And because those vessels or capillaries to carry water are absent, it is mostly called non-porous wood, because it doesn't have those pores, those openings. So it has somewhat even density. Then the lack of vessels also allowed softwoods to absorb adhesives quickly, resulting in a better finish. So you can use adhesives better with it, because they are absorbed better and they you can work quickly with softwoods. And softwood is commonly used in building materials like structural frames, exterior and internal wall claddings, fittings, floorings, formwork, and scaffolding, because it is cheaper. That's why it's, well, not in India, but yes, in the US it is used for formwork and scaffolding because it's cheaper than hardwood. So you can just use it and remove it. In India, we use bamboos for scaffolding or metal frames. It is also used in the paper and cardboard industry because softwood pulp can be used to make paper. It comes with loose grain, higher serpentine. See, what it means is, if you notice in all of these hardwoods, the grain is quite close together. Akriti, you're always late in class. Why?
Sorry, ma'am.
These are online classes. You can't even say that you left from home late or you woke up late. Online classes, and you don't have to come to the department and you're still late. So in hardwoods, if you notice, all of these grains are very close together. These lines are very close together, and all of these, even teak and cherry, birch, all of these have very tightly packed grains. However, in softwoods, the grain is less dense. It has loose grain and it has higher sap content. See, sap is, like I've told you, sap is that viscous thick liquid that comes out of the sap. See, we've already talked about hardwood, heartwood, meaning the core of the tree trunk, and the sapwood, which is the outer circle of the outer layer of the tree trunk. And in softwoods, this sapwood contains this sap or thick viscous liquid like liquid that oozes out if you cut it. Good example would be rubber. Rubber is also a sap of rubber plant. It has higher sap content and it has lighter color as compared to hardwoods, but it's not a rule. It's not necessary that all softwoods have lighter color than all hardwoods, because if you remember, ash and beech, they're both fairly light colored. They're almost white. And some softwoods, there are some softwoods that are quite dark in color, like fir. Cedar is kind of medium. So you can say most of them have lighter color, but it's not compulsory. There are exceptions, just like all hardwoods are not dark in color. And there is another fact that softwoods have poor fire resistance. And it is fine and lightweight structure, in structure, which makes it the best wood for furniture. Because furniture, if furniture is too heavy, it will be difficult to move around. Then we don't have as many softwoods naturally available in India, different types, because India is mostly, India is a subtropical country and we have mostly warmer climates, except for the Himalayas and the northeastern regions where we have quite a lot of mountain ranges. And as you know, softwoods are coniferous trees which grow in colder climates. So they're only found at high altitudes in India, like in Kashmir, Jammu, all those places, Himachal. So we don't have a lot of varieties, not a lot of species in India, but they can be imported. So first one is pine. Piranha pine trees, also called Brazilian pine, are native to southern Americas, especially Brazil. It is free from resin ducts. Resin or sap. Sap is a kind of resin. So if a lot of softwoods have sap, then they will also have vessels or ducts that carry that sap. So pine doesn't have a lot of it, so there are it is it doesn't have resin ducts. It or pitch pockets and pitch streaks. So it's very even. It has a higher shear strength and nail holding capacity, meaning it won't, if a twisting force is applied on it, it won't get damaged easily. That's what it means, shear strength. And nail holding capacity compared to other softwoods. However, it tends to warp. Warp means losing its shape, becoming twisted or changing its original intended shape. And it tends to warp and distort during drying and compression. So, during drying, because all woods have to be dried before, you know, as a part of their processing before they're used in any kind of products or construction. So that, see, if any kind of moisture content is left in a wood, then it will ultimately start to rot. We cannot have dampness in any building material, be it furniture building material or building construction material. So we have to dry these woods, all of the timber. So during the drying process and during compression, it tends to warp. It tends to become distorted. And see, the color of pine wood is the hardwood, meaning the core is light to medium brown and usually has red streaks. And the sapwood, the outer part is yellow. It has light density, but it is still hard. And the grain is straight and uniform. Most common uses include framing lumber, meaning in areas where you see a lot of wooden construction, like in Western countries, in northern regions of India, then this wood, pine wood, is used for the frame, constructing the frame of buildings. Then interior woodwork and sashes. Sashes are they're like the transoms of windows, the central part of the window, vertical dividers of windows, and door stock, meaning as the core material of the doors. And it's used in furniture, case goods, and veneer. You can finish pine wood with the basic finishing materials, and the process of finishing is quite simple for pine. It just needs initial sealing and a few coats. Then we have fir. Fir trees are located throughout most of the northern and central America, Europe and Asia, and North Africa. They usually grow in the mountains, and it comes with low shrinkage and reasonable stability. See, like in pine, we saw that it tends to shrink and warp, but fir doesn't have that problem. It shrinks, but not as much, and it has reasonable stability, meaning it can hold structural forces easily. It doesn't get distorted or doesn't get damaged, and it is also strong and elastic. The color of sapwood, meaning the outer layer of the trunk, is yellowish to reddish white. Fresh heartwood can be yellowish brown to reddish yellow in color. However, it darkens quickly to a brown red to dark red color. And it has medium density and medium weight, and it is fairly hard. Grain is straight and plain and sometimes wavy. So in this case, it is wavy, it's not straight. It's commonly used as veneer because it has a beautiful, beautiful look. It is used as a veneer. It's used for plywood and for construction lumber, meaning it's used in construction. Finishing, it finishes nicely, and you need to take into account that it has a lot of sap. It has a high sap content, so you need a coat of paint. Otherwise, it will kind of destroy the finishing. It makes the finishing, the finish or polish or whatever, it makes it less durable. So you have to finish it with a coat of paint. Then you have cedar. Cedar is quite readily available in India. Cedar is also known to grow in United States, Central America, and South America. It has a red-brown color with light streaks. In India, you will find cedar in Himachal Pradesh. It has a red-brown color with light streaks and beautiful grains on it. And you can easily identify a cedar through its aroma and insect-repellent quality. So you'll find a lot of people prefer their wardrobes, cupboards, and storage, especially clothes, wardrobes for clothes, to be finished and made out of cedar because it repels any kind of insects. So those tiny insects, silverfish and all those insects that tend to burrow holes in your clothes will be kept out of your wardrobe if you use this wood. So it's quite popular as a furniture wood, but especially even in that, especially for storage purposes. And it has a very nice smell, and it is moderately expensive, and it is a kind of a soft wood. The color of hardwood tends to be red or violet brown, and the sap wood is pale yellow or whitish, and it has a hard texture and it is lightweight. It has a straight grain. In this, you can only see the straight grain and not knots, but it does have a lot of knots. Common uses include fence posts, closet, and chest linings. See, this is what I was saying. Closets and chests are lined with cedar, if not completely made out of it, so that your clothes and fabrics are protected. It's used in carvings because it is a soft wood and it has a beautiful color and finish. So it's used in carvings. For bows, those crossbows you have for archery, those bows, and small wooden specialty items. Finishing, it finishes well, but oil finishes are recommended. So hardwood versus softwood. Hardwood comes from angiosperm trees that are not monocots, meaning trees that have broad leaves and have vessels, capillaries that transport water through the wood under a microscope. Before I continue with this, do you guys have any doubts? Does anybody have any doubts?
No.
Okay. It has capillaries. Hardwood trees have capillaries because, see, instead of just, I'll explain why. There is a logical explanation because hardwood trees have broad leaves, like your mango trees, ashok trees, broad leaves. It doesn't have needles. They have broad leaves, and because broad leaves transpire water, so they tend to need more water. Hardwood trees need more water, and because they need more water content to go up to their leaves, and they're very tall trees, so they need capillaries and vessels within those trunks to transport that water from the soil to the highest point in the tree. And that affects its cross section, meaning it has a lot of pores. But on the other hand, softwoods have needles instead of trees. There's the softwood. Hold on. Yeah, so these kind of trees are called coniferous trees, and instead of instead of leaves, they have these needles, needle-like greenery, as opposed to broad-leaf trees, which are they have leaves like this. So because of having a lot of needles and less surface area for the transpiration to occur, they don't have a lot of vessels. And they are needles and cones. Medullary rays and trachytes transport water and produce sap. When viewed under a microscope, softwoods have no visible pores because of trachytes. Hardwoods are most likely found in high quality furniture, decks, flooring, and construction that needs to be long lasting. And we already know why, because they're durable, they're harder, they have better density than softwood, so they tend to last longer. And about all of 80% of all timber comes from softwoods. Softwoods have a wide range of applications and are found in building components like windows, doors, furniture, MDF boards, and paper, etc. Examples of hardwood are elder बालसा बीच, हिकरी। हिकरी इज अ गुड इज अ वेरी वेरी सॉट आफ्टर वुड फॉर बर्निंग, यू नो, फॉर कैंप फायर्स, फॉर फायर प्लेसेस। हिकरी इज अ वेरी सॉट आफ्टर वुड बिकॉज इट हैज़ अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल अरोमा व्हेन इट बर्न्स, एंड इट्स ऑल्सो यूज बाय सम रेस्टोरेंट्स टू, यू नो, फॉर बारबिक्यूज एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट, बिकॉज इट गिव्स अ वेरी नाइस अरोमा टू द फूड। मोस्ट हार्ड वुड्स, सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सॉफ्ट वुड आर सीडर, वी ऑलरेडी टॉक्ट अबाउट इट, फर, वी टॉक्ट अबाउट दिस, जूनिपर इज नॉट वेरी, यू नो, पॉपुलर इन इंडिया, इट्स नॉट, वी डोंट सी अ लॉट ऑफ जूनिपर ट्रीज इन इंडिया। पाइन, रेडवुड, स्प्रूस, वी हैव रेडवुड इन, यू नो, मनाली। मनाली इज क्वाइट फेमस फॉर रेडवुड ट्रीज। देन मोस्ट हार्डवुड्स हैव अ हायर डेंसिटी देन मोस्ट सॉफ्ट वुड्स एंड कॉन सिमिलरली वाइस वर्सा। कॉस्ट, हार्डवुड इज मोस्टली मोर एक्सपेंसिव देन सॉफ्ट वुड्स, एंड सॉफ्ट वुड्स आर लेस एक्सपेंसिव दैन हार्ड वुड्स। हार्ड वुड हैज़ अ स्लोअर ग्रोथ रेट एंड सॉफ्ट वुड हैज़ अ फास्टर रेट ऑफ ग्रोथ। शेडिंग ऑफ लीव्स, हार्ड वुड शेड देयर लीव्स ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इन ऑटम एंड विंटर, सॉफ्ट वुड्स टेंड टू कीप देयर नीडल्स थ्रू आउट द ईयर। एंड हार्ड वुड इज मोर फायर रेजिस्टेंट, वेयर एज सॉफ्ट वुड हैज लो फायर रेजिस्टेंस। सो व्हेन आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट दीज ट्राइकाइड्स एंड वेसल्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट, दीज, इफ यू कैन नोटिस दीज होल्स, these pores, this is under a, if you view hardwood under a microscope, and if you view softwood under a microscope, in hardwood you'll find these vessels. These are the vessels that carry water, and on the other hand, softwood has very fine trachytes, these tiny tiny pores are trachytes, and this is under a microscope. So when you actually see it with naked eyes and feel the texture of the wood, hardwood tends to be a little more porous and rougher as compared to softwoods. And this is the difference in grain. Pine, which is a softwood, has a finer, smoother grain, whereas this hardwood, which is a maple wood, has a little more color and rougher grain. There are differences between the physical structures of hardwoods and softwoods. This is usually visible at a microscopic level and the surface as well. See, you can see it here as well. The cedar, pine, they have such beautiful soft texture. You can even see, feel the texture from the image as compared to rosewood, especially oak has a quite rough texture. See? Yeah. We will continue with this difference. We have almost already discussed all of it. And before going into too much detail, I think, yes?
Ma'am, rosewood mein, hardwood mein mein aate hain, but this rosewood yani sisam. So, ma'am, wo softwood mein mein kaise?
Softwood mein kahan hai, beta?
मैम वो आपने डिफरेंसेस मैम आपने बताया ना हार्डवुड और
सॉफ्टवुड। सी, ये रेडवुड है।
अच्छा,
होल्ड ऑन,
ओके
लेट मी
ओके
शेयर माय स्क्रीन. Laptop isn't working right now, hold on. But until then, it was actually the hardwood is shisham is rosewood, and the one that I was talking about in softwoods was redwood. See, this was this is rosewood, right? And we have redwood in softwoods. Redwood looks like. And redwood is the name of the tree. So when we talk about the timber that comes from redwood trees, it's called redwood wood. Hold on. See. This is wood. Redwood wood looks like, and it comes from these trees. These trees, which are actually quite high, quite tall. Now we mostly have post redwoods, which can go up to 400 feet tall. Which means 91 to 120 meters. 120 meters means, I'll give you an example. Are the typical height of one floor of any building is 3 meters, 3 to 4 meters. So 120 meters means 40 story tall building. See, this is the human scale. This is the human scale. These are fully grown adults. रेडवुड को हिंदी में सकोया बोलते हैं मोस्टली. एंड दिस दीज ट्रीज आर मोस्टली फाउंड इन मनाली एंड दीज आर क्वाइट रेयर इन इंडिया बट यू फाइंड देम इन कोस्टल एरियाज. Coastal areas. See, redwood trees mostly found in the regions of central and southern India. So, especially in Kerala and hilly areas where you have clayey soil. So, before we proceed with the rest of the theory, I would like you guys to actually see the difference in the kind of furniture we find in hardwoods and the furniture we see in softwoods. Because furniture dono se banta hai, softwood se bhi banta hai, hardwood se bhi banta hai. Do a case study, an online case study. Find, maybe decide on one kind of furniture. Maybe if you decide on a study table, so find a study table or maybe a coffee table or maybe a chair or bed or anything, any piece of furniture. Find one that is made in hardwood and find one that is made in softwood and see uska design, uski quality kya hai, right? Make a sketch of it. Find all the information, label it in the sketch and prepare a A3 sheet. It's fine, A3 sheet pe, you can make nice neat sketches, not freehand rough sketches. Try to make them neatly. Okay, so start looking for, start doing the at least online part of it, and I will get back to you in 10 minutes. सबसे पहले तो डिसाइड व्हाट फर्नीचर यू वांट टू चूज. कुछ डिसाइड किया आप लोगों ने, क्या क्या फर्नीचर चूज किया? चारू आकृति?
यस मैम.
व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू स्टडी, व्हिच फर्नीचर?
मैम अभी नहीं पढ़ा मैंने.
पढ़ा नहीं, चलो कोई बात नहीं. आपको एक कोई फर्नीचर डिसाइड करना था जिसमें आप दो टाइप के फर्नीचर हार्डवुड में या सॉफ्टवुड में ढूंढोगे. तो वो या तो टेबल हो सकता है, सोफा, चेयर, बेड, कुछ भी हो सकता है, ड्रेसर भी हो सकता है.
ओके मैम.
श्रुति शिवानी
मैम, मैंने वॉलेट मैम हार्डवुड में वॉलेट मैम चेयर और बेड डिसाइड किया.
ओके ठीक है, तो अभी क्या करेंगे, मतलब व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज जस्ट ऑनलाइन इनके एग्जांपल्स ढूंढो कि सॉफ्टवुड बेड. सॉफ्टवुड में भी नाउ यू नो कि कौन कौन से टाइप के होते हैं. आई एम गोइंग टू अपलोड दिस पीपीटी इन द क्लासरूम, तो यू कैन फाइंड दिस देयर. इफ यू देखना है तो यू कैन फाइंड इट. तो ढूंढ लो कि पाइन में कौन से कैसे बेड होते हैं, सीडर में कैसे बेड होते हैं, या फिर इस तरह से सर्च करो. एंड इफ यू फाइंड समथिंग नाइस दोनों में ढूंढ लो, हार्डवुड में एंड सॉफ्टवुड में, एंड देन उस पर स्टडी कर लो, मेक अ स्केच, उसमें चीज़ें देखो, डिफरेंसेस देखो कि क्या है, कलर में होगा, ग्रेन में होगा, फिनिशिंग में होगा, कार्विंग अलग टाइप की होगी, है उस टाइप पर जो भी ऑब्जर्वेशन आप नोटिस करो, नथिंग इज रॉन्ग, एवरी ऑब्जर्वेशन इज करेक्ट अगर आप उसे ठीक से देख रहे हो तो. ठीक है, डू दिस एंड अब वी विल मीट आफ्टर द समर वेकेशंस एंड